So that day we discussed that when the reporting verb is in past tense, tense of reporting speech changes from present to past and past to past perfect. So what that exactly means, some children need the rules exactly, though that rule is complete in itself. When I say present to past and past to past perfect, then afterwards no change. So when I mean like this, so what I mean, present indefinite, it changes to past indefinite. And past indefinite changes to past perfect. Right? This is rule number one. In rule number one, two rules have come. One, this to this, and this to this. Second rule is, when it is present continuous, it changes to past continuous. And past continuous changes to? Yes, past perfect continuous. Right? Rule number two has also got three rules in it. Present continuous changes to past continuous. Past continuous further changes to past perfect continuous. So remember, perfect, perfect, perfect. Then what? Present perfect changes to past perfect. And then past perfect changes to no change. Why so? Because this is the rule. This was the rule over here. Past perfect here. So past perfect, it won't change. So in rule number three, there is only one rule. In rule number four, present perfect continuous, it will change into past perfect continuous, and it will change into no change, because past perfect doesn't change. So no change. Now what is left? Future perfect continuous. It changes into, for example, I'll be going to market today. Yes, tomorrow. No change. So future continuous also doesn't change. Right? Are you sure? He said, I will be going to market tomorrow. Yes. So will change into would or should. So in a way, future continuous, you can't say that future perfect continuous will become past future, nothing like that. But yes, V1 will change into V2. Will change into would, or shall change into would. Shall will not change into should. Shall and should. Should is absolutely different thing. So tense wise no change, but yes, will or shall, will change into would. That you have to remember. Will, can, may. So all modals change into second form. If it comes will or can or may, right? So even shall ka would, not would, right? Because when I say, I shall be going to market tomorrow. So shall ka banega would. Because would is something else, but should is totally different meaning. I should go to, I should be going. But even if you change, it won't be wrong. No grammatically, no hard and fast rule regarding it, because modals are related to future, and future is not a time basically. It's only a planning. If I say I'll be going to Delhi tomorrow, or if I say I might be going to Delhi tomorrow, if I say I will be going, can be going to, I shall be going to, I might be going to, they all are somewhere or the other same meaning. They all carry the same meaning. Some might be a strong, argument, or somewhere I might be just making a guess, or somewhere I might just be giving my point of view. If I say I will be, that means I'm determined. If I say I might be, means I'm not very sure. I may be a little bit more sure than when I say I might be. Okay, so I could be, possibility is there. I can be, there is a possibility. I may, less possibility, right? But they all are related to future. So you have to change the first form into second form, but doesn't mean that future perfect continuous is going to change into past, future and all, nothing. Got it? So is that clear regarding the rules? So these rules are applicable when the reporting verb is in past tense. Remember, if the reporting verb is in present or future, then these rules are nullified. They don't apply then. Is that clear? You can note down these rules. But these rules, you know, their base is present tense to past and past tense to past perfect. That's the base. Okay. So you can note down, it will, you will take 2 minutes. And do you people also note down everything? Don't just take the screenshot. Screenshots remain hidden in your gallery, and sometimes it gets deleted. Yeah? So always note down. Don't depend upon the screenshots. And when you write, then your hands also become, they also do exercise. Okay, otherwise your hands will become very lazy. They might have already become. Shall we talk to somebody here? Whom should we talk to? Prabhnoor. Okay, Prabhnoor is here. Yes, Prabhnoor, your friends are missing you. Prabhnoor, unmute yourself.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Prabhnoor, how are you?
Fine.
So, do you want to talk to somebody? Are you having your breakfast?
No, it's... Yes.
Okay. So I would not ask you your menu of your breakfast. Okay, anyways. You right now, you note down the rules. Later on, you enjoy your prantha. Okay. So, have you written these rules? Prabhnoor, I'll call your mother.
Yes, ma'am.
I'll call your mother today. Okay. Okay, mute yourself. Okay. So, when you're at home, it's okay. We can have fun, but still, there should be a little routine. You know, when the break is there, then have food. Okay, that is why the online classes, children are not able to learn as much as they could have learned. You being at home, so comfortable. Basically, here also you're listening and there also you can listen. Same thing is there. But the only difference is discipline. Okay, we can learn to be disciplined at home also, provided we want. Right? Discipline is must. Otherwise, so comfortable being at home. Okay? Okay, so I'll be talking to Prabhnoor, your mother, today. Okay, just because I want, like, the children should be disciplined at home. What's the time now? 9:22. And at 9:40, there will be a break. From 9:40 to 10:10, there will be a break. Am I right?
Yes.
From 9:45 to 10:10, there is a break. What will you do then? Then you enjoy the breakfast. Okay. So these rules are applicable when the reporting verb is past. When I say he said, then only. Not he says, not he will say. Right? So these are the rules for maybe interrogative sentences, for imperative sentences, for exclamatory sentences. The rules of tenses will remain same in all kinds of sentences of narration. Right? So now let us do some practice of some simple sentences, then we'll come to interrogative sentences. Though they are the same kind, but still we need to have some practice. Right on. My teacher said to me, comma, inverted comma, start. we will be solving some exercises from grammar book tomorrow. We will be solving some exercises from grammar book tomorrow. We will be solving some grammar exercises from grammar book tomorrow. Write the answer side by side. Okay, Saket, give the answer button. Okay, Diksha, what did he say? Okay, is there any mistake? Yes, Kushi, is there any mistake? Yeah, the next day. Apart from this, is there any other mistake? Where will B go? Future perfect continuous. Which tense is it? B will be. It's future continuous. So future continuous will remain. Yeah, it would become would. Baki B would remain B. Okay, B1 plus ing will remain as it is. So where the rule will be? What the answer would be? My teacher. My teacher told me, okay, my teacher told me that they or we, okay, my teacher told me that we would be solving the, okay, so my teacher told me that we would be solving the grammar exercises from the book the next day. Full stop. Now, next sentence, sit down, children. I said to my sister, I've decided to become a photographer. I've decided to become a photographer. Yes, Arshin. Yeah. I told my sister that I had decided to become a photographer. I told my sister that I had decided. Okay. Okay, next sentence. My sister said to me, you should think for 100 times before coming to a conclusion. You should think for 100 times before coming to a conclusion. Yes, Jyotsroop, give the answer. Jyotsroop.
I told my sister that I had decided to become a photographer.
Repeat, Peta.
I told my sister that I had decided to become a photographer.
Yeah, that we have done. Okay, now next one. I spoke one more sentence. My sister said to me, you should think for 100 times before coming to a conclusion. Okay, you.
My sister told me that. My sister told me that. I used to think 100 times.
Yes, you are right. So my sister told me that I should. Yeah, that is also correct. So when it is you should, it's an advice. So my sister advised me that I should think for 100 times before coming to a conclusion. So you'd be right. No, it's okay. But better advice. Yes, when you get MCQs, in MCQ number one, you say it's written like my sister told me. In second, my sister advised me. Then you should go for advice. What should not? Why? You should think should plus V1, should plus V1. Okay, all models take V1. Okay, don't commit this mistake. Okay, now next sentence now. So from simple sentences, one more we can do. My sister said to me, my sister said to me, you did not get good marks in your previous term. You did not get good marks in your previous term. And now we are expecting, and now we are expecting good results from you. And now we are expecting good results from you. Gursevak, be ready to give answer. I'm repeating the sentence. My sister said to me, you did not get good marks in the previous exams, and now we are expecting good results from you. And now we are expecting good results from you. Okay, Gursevak from here. Gursevak, unmute yourself. Gursevak. Aditya, unmute yourself. Aditya. Even Aditya is not answering today. Okay, so yes, Aryansh. Okay, Aryansh, it's okay, good. But do we change tenses? My sister said to me, said means past, right? When there is a reporting verb is in past, then these rules apply. My sister told me that. So she said, like, you did not get. So what is did not get? Did not get is past indefinite. Did not get is past indefinite. And past indefinite changes into what I'm doing? Past indefinite. It was past indefinite, and past indefinite will change into past perfect. Right? So past indefinite will change into past perfect. So what's the rule of past perfect? Had. Had not got or gotten even. GOTTEN. So point is, my sister told me that I had not got good marks in the previous term. Wait. We use? My sister told me that I had not got, okay, had plus third form of verb. Okay, so what you are saying? It's not so. Did, with did we, yes, use first form of verb, but with had we use third form of verb. Good morning. Never mind. Okay. So my sister told me that I had not got good marks in the previous term. In the last term. It's okay. Even previous is okay. 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 If the last was there, then previous would definitely come. But previous doesn't have to come back to last. Okay. So my sister told me that I had not got good marks in the previous term. It's okay. Now full stop. One more sentence is there. And now we are expecting good results from you. So what we will say? Wait, wait. First of all, we will be adding one more reporting verb now. Or reporting. No? So, and she further. And she added. And she added that they were expecting good results from me then. Because now is here, now will become then. And she added, and she further added that she or they were expecting good results from me then. Done? Both are correct. Okay, now next sentence. I wanted to do interrogative sentences today. Shall we start interrogative now? How much time left? Okay, 5-6 minutes are there. We can start one more concept. So let's see. Where's the duster? Yes, now write down interrogative sentences. So when the reporting speech is interrogative, reporting verb, I have already told you that when it is past, then those rules will apply. My friend said to me, I said to him, she said to me, she said, whatever. There the rules would remain same. But now when the reporting speech is interrogative, then these rules you might have written. Okay, interrogative sentences are of two kinds. When reporting speech is interrogative. Starting with verb, helping verb. So when the interrogative question, when the question starts with a verb, then what will you do? For example, starting with, for example, be, do, or have verbs. Be, do, have. Be means is, am, are, was, were. Right? Do means do, did, does. Have, has, had. So when any sentence starts with any of these three verbs, then we use if as a linker. Then we use if or whether as a linker, not that. So when a question starts with be, do, or have verbs, then we use the linker if or whether, not that. We don't use that in the interrogative sentences. In the interrogative sentences, we use if or whether when the question is starting with be, do, or have. Or in very simple terms, when the question, when it is a yes, no kind of question, then we take if or whether. Okay, that is easier form. if the question is a yes no kind of question. For example, if I say, will you go there? Are you going to market? Have you done your work? Do you like it? These all questions are in yes or no forms. Okay, so when you get these kinds of questions, then you are to use if or whether instead of that as a linker. Got it? Now write a rule. Sentence number one. My sister said to me, are you working hard to get good marks? My sister said to me, my sister said to me, are you working hard to get good score? So here, number one, we have to see here said reporting verb is past. Our tension is over. That we have to apply the same rules which we have learned here. Okay, present to past and past to past perfect, right? So first of all, ascertain that the rule is, it is past. It is past. Now come to second part, it's now what kind of sentence? Are you, it's an interrogative sentence with a yes, no types. Are you working hard? What will you answer? Yes, or you will say no. You won't have any third answer. Either yes or no. But some confusing children will say, but basically the answer would be either yes or no. So are you, so, and secondly, the other rule, basically correct rule is, it is starting with a be form. Okay, when a question starts with any be, do or have form, then we use if or whether. So what will be the answer now? My sister asked me. Yeah. My sister asked me if okay, now if you put instead of the inverted commas, right, instead of inverted commas, if has come. Now here are you, here the verb is there and then subject is there, but you will make the subject first. So who is you? If I was, rest of the sentence and in the end full stop. If I was working hard to get good score. You know what some children, one more mistake children do, we never imagine that mistake. Anyone, if you think like something we have not done, that we have done, full stop ho gaya, na? Anything which you think like you might, no, you know children, you know, they say, they think like present has to become past, so they also make it past to God. So what you should remember that infinitives, 2 plus V1, okay, 2 always carries V1. And it's not the helping verb over here. It's an infinitive. We don't even have to touch it. Infinitives, gerunds are not to be touched. Participles. We have to only take care of the main verb. And the main verb over here was are. R has become was or were. Okay, now next sentence. My sister said to me, let it be same. Now make it. My sister said to me, did you take your lunch? Did you take your lunch? Did you take your lunch in the morning? You didn't? You might have taken breakfast. How could you take lunch in the morning? Yes, very good. Okay, the rest of the students. Aryansh, can you try? Aryansh. My sister said to me, will become. My sister asked me, not that when there is an interrogative sentence, we use if. My sister asked me if. Instead of inverted commas, we have to use if. Don't forget it. My sister asked me if you will become I if I had. Did becomes had in the narration. Did becomes had. Past indefinite becomes past perfect. Okay, did becomes had. If I had taken third form now. If I had taken my lunch. Full stop in the end. Okay. Okay, write one more sentence like this. The other interrogative form we will do tomorrow. My mother said to me. My mother said to me. Will you come? Will you come at? Will you come at 12:30? Will you come at 12:30? Question mark. So, my mother said to me, my mother asked me if, yes, very good, Aryansh. So, my mother told, asked me if I would come at 12:30, right? Okay.